Hello everybody, this is Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and before we get into this video, I want to thank everybody for the huge amount of support the channel has been getting recently. We're up to nearly 140 subscribers, and that for a channel with like 16 videos is amazing. So thank you very much, let's keep that going, and let's get on with the video. So I was planning on making a video about all the features that motherboards have, because I know those can get pretty confusing. But then I realized that some of those features need a video of their own before I can make the big one. So, here we are, talking about the motherboard chipset. What on earth does it do? Can a better one make your PC faster? Let's take a look. You might not spend a lot of time thinking about the motherboard chipset, but your whole motherboard is in fact built around it. It used to be made up of a set of two separate chips, the North Bridge and the South Bridge, hence the name chipset. But in recent years, most chipsets have moved to a single chip. But that is pretty unimportant. What you want to know is what effect the chipset you buy will have on the performance of your PC. Well, the truth is that the chipset is just an information hub. And just like the motherboard as a whole, the chipset isn't about performance. It's all about features. So, here is a list of things it determines. The supported generation of USB, the number of USB ports, the number of SATA ports, the PCI Express version, the number and types of PCI configurations, the RAM configuration, support for various technologies such as Intel Optane memory, and probably the one feature that everyone who is relatively tech savvy knows and cares about, support for overclocking. So the question on your mind right now might be, if the chipset is so important for your system, since it is basically the brain of your motherboard, and all of the information in your system has to pass through it, why does it get so little attention? And the answer is, because it doesn't need attention. The only thing you need to know about it is whether it supports overclocking, and that's pretty simple. For Intel, chipsets Z and X support overclocking, while chipsets H and B don't. For AMD Ryzen, the X and B chipset support overclocking, while the A chipset doesn't. For all the other features, you need to look at the motherboard instead of the chipset for a single, simple reason. The motherboard manufacturer decides which features of the chipset they will implement into their board, and to which extent. For example, even though chipset X299 supports up to 10 USB 3.0 ports, your motherboard might only have 6 or 8 or whatever number they choose. So, conclusion time. Is the chipset important? Yes, very much so. Does it affect performance? No, at least not directly. Can you keep ignoring everything about it except for overclocking support? Yes, but at least now you know why. So I really do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more, you can click on the right to watch my latest video, or on the left to watch a random video, or just click the round channel icon in the middle to subscribe. And as always, this has been Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, bye bye.